So this video is predominantly about this little sexy looking camera here, the Fujifilm X100V. This is basically the newest addition in the X100 series line by the company Fujifilm. The V stands for 5, so it's the fifth version of this camera essentially. For those of you that don't know much about these cameras, they're essentially just very small, sort of compact, portable, fixed focal length cameras. They're a crop sensor, but it's got the equivalent of a 35mm in full frame terms focal length on there. And they're just really easy to use, fun cameras, very good for sort of documentary work, whether that be, you know, street photography, weddings, or my personal favorite, of course, family documentary. And I think this is really where these cameras come into their own, especially this new version that's got like 4K up to 30 frames per second recording as well. This isn't actually my camera. I borrowed this off a YouTuber friend, Zane Reza. We basically just did a camera swap, so I gave him my GFX for about a week or so, and he lent me this. And we went away to Dorset, and I took this with us and just kind of documented it, photos and video, all just taken on this, and I'm going to share like a little video with you about that as well. At this time of the year, I would usually have enough money to be able to afford one of these. I know it's been out a while now, and I've been hankering after one since they came out. Usually, in a year, I'd work something like between 50 and 60 weddings, in all honesty, and this year I've worked 10, maybe 11 at a push. So it's been a very different year, and I know a lot of people have been struggling this year when it comes to, you know, just life, mental health, finances and stuff like that, but we've particularly had a pretty pants year in terms of work and other things that have been going on. You know, we've lost a grandparent recently, and we've got another one kind of on their deathbed, and not being able to see them and stuff like that has been really bad. And obviously at this stage in the year, usually we'd have like a nice sort of nest egg to be able to not just live off of, but, you know, invest back in my business. And I would have bought something like the Fuji X100V. I would have probably upgraded my X-T3s to X-T4s. I wanted to get like a specific film camera, a Mamiya RZ67 and stuff as well. But just because of what's been going on, we simply, you know, can't afford it at the moment, and I'm sure many other people are in the same boat, especially when it comes to things like the wedding industry. It's just been crippled to its knees. You know, I know so many other suppliers, photographers and stuff like that are really struggling, and it's been a pardon my friends, it's been a fucking shit year, to be honest with you, and it's not over. It feels like a never ending episode of, you know, Black Mirror or something. I'm waiting for Charlie Brooker to kind of pop out and be like, ha, I got ya. But yeah, that's not happened yet. So nonetheless, we had, you know, we worked a few weddings recently. I had a little bit of money, and we booked like a cheap cottage down in Dorset. Sort of, it was actually on the Isle of Portland, which is just by opposite like Weymouth on the southwest coast of England. I just, you know, I kind of knew that another lockdown was coming, and it was half term. We had it off with the kids. We only went for 3 nights, like 4 days, but it was just nice to get away with the kids. We kind of like, I unplugged, come off all social media, left my laptop at home. I literally just went away with just me, my family and this camera. And like these cameras just come into their own when you're just documenting your family and stuff like that. So I'm going to show you the video now, which is just, I pieced together some photos and a little bit of footage and stuff, and then I'll come back and talk to you about my thoughts on the camera a bit more. So yeah, so we had a great time when we were down there. I know we were only there for like a couple of days, but it was just, it's really nice to kind of like unplug, get away from social media and work emails and stuff like that, and just kind of forget what was going on in the world at the moment. And you know, we managed to do that, and hopefully you got the gist from the video, like just kind of like the power of this little camera. You know, it's so small and portable and easy to use, but like the pictures that come out of it are amazing and the footage is really good. I know it doesn't have image stabilization, so the footage can be a bit jittery and stuff, but like for family documentary movies, personally I don't mind that. I think it kind of adds a little bit to like the nostalgia and stuff, but you can always use a gimbal or something like that. I've tested it with a gimbal and it works fine, you know, if you really want that smooth footage. But for me, just being able to have something in my pocket that I can pull out, take a quick clip or take a quick picture and then pop back in my pocket and just carry on enjoying the moment is just the perfect kind of setup. And yeah, hopefully things will get back to normal soon, and I'll be able to afford one of my own. But yeah, I mean, we're lucky we went away when we did, because we literally got back and the next day they announced that we're going back into a month-long lockdown. And you know, the couple of weddings I did have left for the year have now been postponed to the 2022, so I've not got a lot going on for the rest of the year, in all honesty, so expect a few more videos from me. I did actually shoot some film when I was down there, put some film from my Mamiya C330 TLR, so I'm going to do a separate video for that once I've got the film developed. But yeah, I just want to say again, like, thanks. I really do appreciate everyone that watches my videos. I think it's really important when you've got a platform like this where people are listening to what you're saying, to almost, you know, have something important to say. And I've spoken to people, you know, quite a few people individually that are struggling financially or with their mental health and stuff like that. And, you know, I just want to say my inbox is always open if you want to have a chat. You know, I'm happy to chat with anyone about this kind of stuff. But yeah, thanks for watching and hopefully see you in the next video.